It's not my shoot time yet. It's my leisure time. We'll shoot later. Today we have the XGMI's Halo portable projector. Now don't let the size fool you. This little guy can provide you non-stop or an uninterrupted playback of 4 hours on one single charge. Supports full HD 1080 in terms of resolution. Also supports 4K video output. And it has a built-in Harman Kardon speaker, so you don't need to connect an external speaker for an audio output. Now, isn't that a great thing? With respect to the construction of the Halo, it's very well constructed. It looks like a masterpiece with minimalistic design. It's encased in a proper polished aluminum casing with plastic overheads, and the back casing again is plastic. There are ports at the back. There is an HDMI port. There's a USB pen drive support port. And there is also an output jack for your audio output in case you want to connect your audio devices of your preference. There is also a DC port that is used for charging the device when you are not running it on the battery. Just below that are the vents for the airflow. Now, we did talk about the portability aspects of the Halo, but what about the practical aspects of the Halo projector? In this case, it does have its own onboard operating system. And if you've guessed it right, it's Android TV and it's on version 9 already. With respect to the processor, it's running the AM Logic T950X2 processor. There's a GPU, which is the Mali G31, 2 gigs of RAM and 16 gigs of ROM. That's something that you find in high-end Android TVs. The additional piece of hardware is on the external, which is the optical sensor. What it does is, every time I move the projector, obviously the viewing distance or the distance of projection changes. It automatically readjusts itself depending on the position that the projector is from the wall. So that's a quick demo. And just like that, you're done. You don't need to do anything. I mean, is this that lazy, or we're lazy and that's more efficient? That's for you guys to decide. So we've factored in the practicality, we've factored in the portability, but the most important bit is going to be the picture quality. To be very honest, I like the picture quality. It's 800 luminous, so you can't really expect to take it out on brighter sunlight or even bright illuminated rooms and expect it to give brighter outputs. Right now, I'm in a subtle dim conditions in terms of viewing, but I'm having some great viewing experience in terms of the picture quality. And to add to the whole benefit of the picture that I get as an output from the Halo, it also supports HDR content. So watching videos which are now more HDR supported, even on YouTube, it's an amazing experience in itself. Don't believe me? I got it projected on my wall here in the office, just set up here to make it look like I'm at home. But this is our office. Now, I'm already at a distance of more than 12 feet here, but I have an 88-inch viewing screen here in front of me, which I can increase more if I put out the lights completely. So, just to gauge out, if you have a party at home, you have your friends over, this is something that you can do on an occasional basis. You can even carry these to somebody else's place. Or maybe you're out for an outing, sitting, you have a plain wall, just project whatever you want. That is the kind of picture quality that you get from this small device out here called as the Halo, and it's living up to its name so far. Now, I do want to conclude this video, give you a proper verdict on this, but I'm not able to find a single point where I can mark this down, and I'm sorry if this has felt like more of a commercial than a review video. You can blame it on the XGMI's Halo because it indefinitely is a very good product. There is one point, however, which you can say is a negative, which is the cost. Or the price, it retails for around 90,000, which for some people might be a lot, and it's right enough to think so as well, because a lot of you guys will think, if I have to invest 90,000 on a projector, I might as well invest on a proper Android TV. Well, you can do that, but then you'll have it parked in your living room or maybe in your bedroom for the remainder of its lifetime. But if you are an outdoor person who likes to travel, maybe goes to his friend's house, you want to watch MotoGP or even watch a cricket match, this is something that you can carry around and you can accommodate more people with a larger display. Do like us and subscribe to us if you've liked what we're doing. Do comment if there's any crazy content or tech product that you would like us to feature. This is Aurelius signing off from Pinkula Tech. Have a great evening ahead.